Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about breaking bad news, Spike's protocol. I'm Dr. Suresh Badanmat, Professor of Psychiatry, working at NIMHANS, Bangalore. Before I start my presentation, I would like to place a disclaimer. This presentation is for academic and training purpose only. This presentation is not a substitute for professional opinion. For professional opinion, please do contact a registered medical practitioner. Conflict of interest? None. Breaking bad news. This is the biggest challenge for any healthcare professional when he has to convey the bad news to the patient or to the patient's family members. And unfortunately, most of the medical college do not teach about breaking bad news. Hence, only 1/3 of the health professionals have been trained in breaking bad news. Hence, the Spike's protocol plays a crucial role in training healthcare professionals in breaking bad news. In this video, I'm going to discuss about the Spike's protocol, and I'll be discussing about the objectives and the steps in the Spike's protocol. The Spike's, each word indicates the steps. The word Spike's has 6 letters, hence there are 6 steps have been indicated in the Spike's protocol. Let's understand the objectives. The objectives of the Spike's protocol is gathering the information from the patient and the family members, transmitting the information which is required to break the bad news and to clarify doubts, providing support to the patient and or to the family members of the patient, and finally to collaborate with the patient and or with the family members to process the bad news and to go through the grief process. Let's understand this 6 steps of Spike's protocol. S stands for setting up the interview. P stands for assessing the patient's perception of the bad news. I stands for obtaining patient's invitation. And K stands for giving knowledge and information to the patient and the patient family members. E stands for addressing the emotion with empathic response both to the patient and or to the family members, and summarizing. So these are the 6 steps which you should know to break the bad news. And these 6 steps are easy to learn, inculcate, and to practice. Summarizing the 6 steps: S, setting up the interview. P, the perception of the bad news by the patient or the family members, inviting to know the information, providing knowledge, empathy, and summary. So these are the 6 steps. Let's go through the each steps. First and the foremost, setting up the interview. The interview should be planned. There should be privacy place. Confidentiality should be maintained. When the interview takes place, there should be no interruption. Mobile phones should be kept off or in the silent mode. Family members who are significantly involved with the patient's decision has to be called in. And the consent has to be taken with regard to confidentiality. And the person who is going to break the bad news should have gone through the medical records thoroughly. You should not give false information or else make mistakes when providing the information, because we are talking about serious matter here. At the same time, when you are providing the information, only relevant team members should be there from the healthcare professional side. And please do remember, have a right place, right time to break the bad news. Hence, setting up the interview, it is very essential. Coming to the second, assess the patient perception of the situation, or else if the patient is no more, assess the perception of the family members about the patient situation. First, invite them and ask them what do they think about the patient's condition, or else what do the patient thinks about his condition. What is their understanding? What is their prognosis? Invariably, they would have done their homework. They would have contacted some family members, healthcare providers, maybe even internet. They would have Googled also. Once you know what they have understood, now is the time to introduce your team members and also ask for the introduction of each family member and ask, is there anyone who would like to speak about the patient or the patient side who would like to address about the current condition. Ask the family members how much they want to know. At the same time, whether they know the prognosis is to what condition it is very bad. At the same time, indirectly assess how the family is interacting, where the patient's decision maker is sitting, where the other family members are sitting, who is speaking, who is taking decision, and how the family members are interacting, because this plays a crucial role to understand the family dynamics so that you can address the particular person who is the leader in the family. If there is a high noise level, you need to control the noise level within the family, because sometimes the family starts fighting, blaming each other when the breaking bad news starts. Hence, you should know the dynamics when you enter the room, how they are placed, who is speaking, what is his name. All those information should be processed. Coming to the third. At the same time, you now obtaining patients and families invitation. That is means how much family members want to know. Now you should start asking, would you like to know completely? How much do you want to know? And also check the family members who were in touch with the treating member, that is treating team member. Ask that person to explain what he knows, because he's the person who would have discussed with the treating team. He plays a crucial role telling that I had discussed ABCD and I have given consent to certain information. If that key person is not there, make sure he is brought in for discussion. At the same time, check how much they want to know, including the patient and also the significant family members. The third one is, now is the time to speak. Share the knowledge with the relevant stakeholders. At the same time, please do keep an eye on the confidentiality. And when you're discussing, avoid medical terms. Explain in simple words. Don't complicate the medical problems, because if you complicate, the patient and the patient family members find it difficult to take decision. Ask them to question. If they have any questions, clarify their doubts. Coming to the important point is addressing the emotion. When you have given the bad news, invariably there will be emotions. Sometimes invariably there will be shock, there will be denial, there will be anger, they will start bargaining, there will be depressed symptoms, or else they may accept also. So the treating team should know the process of grief. Kubler-Ross process of grief should be known, and what stage they are there also should be able to assess by the treating team. Allowing the patient's family to go through this grief, at the same time expressing emotion, should be allowed. If the emotions are too high, you can take a break. Tell the family members you will be back in 5 to 10 minutes. Do not stop to curtail their emotions. This is the time the family is grieving or else ventilating. Sometimes you may have to stay back. So empathetic listening plays a very crucial role. Please do keep an eye on the non-verbal communication, both the patient and also the way you are behaving with the family members when you are breaking the bad news. So non-verbal communication also plays a crucial role. Coming to the last step, summarize the discussion. Ask them whether they have any questions, and also invite them to speak if they want to say something about the care, about the improvement in the care, and also plan for next follow-up. Make sure that your team calls them back. That means in a week, once or twice, your team need to contact if there is any bad news has been communicated, how they have processed, would they like to have an early appointment. The last step, please don't forget, check your own emotions. At the same time, your team members are also grieving because of the loss of the patient. Please do talk to them and debrief them. These are the very essential 6 steps of Spike's model. To conclude, my dear friends, sometimes when you're discussing bad news, you may have uncertainties about the diagnosis, prognosis, or you may have your own doubts regarding the patient's condition. Please discuss this. Do not hide. Do not avoid discussing this. The best way is discuss. Document. The uncertainty has been explained. If you have a doubt, seek second opinion. Ask the family. Encourage them to ask for a second opinion. Help them to find the authenticated information. That allays their anxiety and it helps them to take decision. ask how much they want to know so that you can provide tailored information to the patient and the patient family members. Please understand the grief stages, because every family, every survivor, every patient deals with the grief differently. So knowing that stage helps you to make their journey smooth. At the same time, don't forget to have follow-up. At times, you may require to provide one-on-one counseling. And if the grief is very high, please refer them to a mental health counselor. Thank you very much for giving your valuable time. Stay safe.